Hey y'all, it's Ashton. So I have a treat for you guys today. I am here at the Brass Armadillo in Phoenix, Arizona, and I'm going to take you guys inside and show you the amazingness of this store. It's probably one of my favorite places to shop. I absolutely love coming here. Whenever I'm over on this side of town, I always have to stop and take a look. It's probably like heaven on earth here, seriously. So we're gonna take you inside and show you, you know, how to pick out great things, how to find things at good prices, that kind of thing. I'm here with my boyfriend. Say hi, Shay.
Hi.
So he's gonna film me while I show you guys, you know, how to pick out good things, how to find real versus fake, and if you should get it, if you should not get it. I tend to look at quality and price. If it's way too expensive and I know I'm not going to be able to get good return on it, then I won't buy it, no matter how good it is, unless I want it for myself. But so I'll take you guys inside and we'll get to it. And on a side note, I am not affiliated with Brass Armadillo at all. It's just one of my favorite places to shop. So yeah, I'm not affiliated with them, but I will say, if you guys are ever here, definitely stop by. I know there's one in Kansas City. I want to say on the Missouri side of Kansas City, and there's also one in Phoenix, Arizona. I'm not sure where else. I think there's only two or three locations, but definitely if you guys are at either of those, in either of those cities, definitely check it out. But I will take you guys inside, so see you in there. All right, guys, so this is the entrance. As you can see, there's just rows and rows, and my boyfriend, and rows of just all this beautiful stuff. So let's get started. We are gonna go down. When you first come in, on the right side is where all the cases are, where all the glass cases are, where they have stuff behind the cases. And we're not going to spend too much time down here because this is not the stuff that I usually look for, but I just wanted to show you guys. And so we do just have these kind of rows. But what we're going to do is we're going to head on this side where all the furniture is kept and all the little, we're going to actually head down this way. Here, I'm going to have my boyfriend push my cart with my purse. So as you can see, they have all these rows. All the glass cases. Actually, last time I was here, I do want to show you guys something if I can find it. Last time I was here, they had this one case that had like all these oddities in it, and it had like a monkey skeleton and a bat skeleton. I want to see if I can find that again, just because it was so interesting. See if I can figure out where it was. Baby, do you remember where that case was?
Yeah.
Did you find it?
It was on this one, wasn't it? Was it this one?
Oh yeah, here it was. Okay, so as you guys can see all the little skeletons? And like all, and there's the bat skeleton. And hair. I thought this case was really cool last time I was here. If you guys ever seen that show, the Oddity Show, where they had that shop, it was pretty cool. It used to be on Netflix, it's not anymore. But I love this kind of stuff, it's really cool. But yeah, so now that I've showed you guys that, let's head on over to the furniture. Okay, so everybody like brings their antiques and whatnot in here, and they have their own little cubbies. And as you can see, you know, they kind of set up, you know, dealer discounts. Look at this. Look how beautiful this is. They have all different kinds of stuff. And see, I would probably buy the small stuff, you know, like probably this table. Zoom out so you can see. There I am in the mirror. See that? Look how beautiful that is. See this hutch right here is $899. I probably wouldn't buy the hutch because I don't know if I could get that kind of money back on it. And then this little bedroom dresser is $419. And there I am. Hi. All right, let's go see if we can find something that I would buy. I'd probably buy this little umbrella rack. Let's see the price on this thing. And there's no price. I don't see a price on it, but something like this is probably cheap. So I'd probably buy that and refurnish it. Refurbish it actually, and paint it up a cute color. And then look in here. Oh, see, here's a roll top desk. See, I've been looking for one, but this one's kind of small though. See, this is $289. I don't know, but it's in really good condition. There's a pop. This is beautiful. I think this folds down. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that. See, like right now, like I was telling you guys, like I do everything out of my apartment. So I cannot get anything that's overly huge because I don't have the space, but once I do, I would definitely get something like this. This is absolutely gorgeous. I absolutely love this. See if we can find you guys something that I would get. Okay, so here's a chair right here. Can you guys see that? See this chair I'd probably get? It's in pretty good condition. I mean, there are some of the wicker missing though, so I probably wouldn't. Depends on the price. See, it's $22. So it may be worth it, but at the same time, like, I don't know how to fix wicker, so then again, maybe not. But then again, I could also take the wicker out and just put a cushion in there, and it's nice and sturdy otherwise. And for $22, I mean, that's a really good chair. Here's another desk in here. I gotta squeeze in here. Okay, this desk right here is gorgeous. It folds down, if you can see. Looks like this $375. That's gorgeous though. There's a lot of really good old wooden stuff in here. It's really tight in here. Okay, see this wood shelf right here? That would probably be something that I would buy if it's for sale. And it looks like there's a tag, but I can't reach it. It looks like it's $45. Okay, so $45 is a good price. To get, because I would probably turn around and sell it for about $100-$150, and that's nice, and that's real wood. Yeah, that's a good piece. I like stuff like this too, like this wooden box. Let's see, that's $69. That's really good. That would be good to refurbish. Oh look, there's an old school desk. That is awesome. I would definitely buy something like that. See, that's $128, and that's a little steep, but it's a genuine, real school desk. So that's definitely something that I would buy, because you could sell that for a couple hundred dollars. That is really cool. I like the old crates too. I would get the crates. Oh, look at this little chair. 38. I would get this. You can tell this is real wood. See, there's a couple little splits in here, but you could fill that with wood filler. That's really nice. This would be something that I would get, and even this table too would be nice. You could fix all this. You could sand it down and fill it with wood filler. Let's see if we can find a price on this table. I don't see a price on the table though. Even this chair would be nice too. $55 for this chair.
Hi guys.
And I like old washboards. This one's in really great condition and it's $42. I would totally get that too. Look at that chair. Let's see if we can find a price on this chair. Look at the detail on this thing. I don't see a price. But it is gorgeous. Look at that. The detail on it is just absolutely amazing. See what else we can find here. Oh, look at the old Raggedy Ann and Andy. Those are old. Yeah, like I said in a previous video, there's just something about the older stuff than the way things are made now. A lot of care went into the way things were made back then. Alright, I'm gonna pause this video until I can find something for you guys. See if I can find anything in here that's like maybe fake. I don't want to say fake, but you know what I mean. So I will get back to you guys. Hey y'all, so I'm here with Hunter here at the Brass Armadillo in Phoenix, Arizona, and I just wanted to have her talk to you guys about the place and, you know, kind of like the traffic they get here and the stuff they get here. So Hunter, go ahead and tell them about how awesome this place is.
It's so much fun. I love working here a lot. It's actually been my first job. Actually.
Really? Mm-hmm. That's awesome.
Been here for 2 years. It's so much fun.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
2 years, and we get all kinds of amazing stuff here.
Yeah.
Teacups to even modern stuff like little pet shops, toys, plates, books, you name it. We have everything here.
From vintage to modern, huh? That's
pretty cool. Vintage to modern, to even antique. Like, we have 1800 books, chairs, furniture, a lot of things.
Yeah, I noticed you guys had, last time I was here, there was like a whole bookshelf of Stephen King, and I wanted to buy like every single book you guys had.
Yeah, and then there's the whole bookshelf of Dean Koontz also.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Yeah, it's really
That's
awesome.
Pretty cool. Yeah, well, thank you so much, and
yeah,
that's
no
really
problem.
Cool.
Thanks
that's
for
cool.
Meeting
you.
You
have a good day.
Hey guys, so Hunter just told me that there is actually another Brass Armadillo in Goodyear, Arizona that I did not know about. She said it's 2 stories and twice as big as this one, so I'm definitely going to try it out and head out there sometime. I'm so excited about it. I'm like, I love these places. I get so excited. I get so giddy. But check this table out. This table reminds me of that movie, Help Me Out, Babe, Hostel. Check these out. This reminds me of the tools they use in Hostel it's locked. Look at this. Teeth pulling. You get it?
Yeah.
Some like torture device stuff. I like this one though. I don't know what that's for, but look at that. Yeah.
So let's see if we can find some more stuff. If we can find some good stuff to show you guys, okay? Oh, look at this. Can't open that one either. They're like all stuck together. Oh,
I hate dolls. I hate old creepy dolls. They really freak me out. Oh, babe, check this out. Look. It's made from the back of a truck. 1968 Dodge bed bench.
That's awesome.
Let's go this way.
Ooh.
Sorry. I can never make up my mind. Like, you could seriously spend days inside this store. There's, like, you can't come in here and see every single thing and leave in a couple hours. Like, you have to come back for several different times to be able to see everything. I've been here several times and still have not seen everything. You wanna go down? Let's go down this way. Let's see what we can find. Oh, look. Okay, here we go. So first, let's look at price. $189. This, for something like this, $189 is an amazing price. Well, oh my gosh. If I had $189 in a truck, I would get this right now. Look how amazing this is. This is absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. And see, this would be something that I would restore. I would not refurbish it, and I would not repurpose it. I would restore this. I would probably just fix all the little nooks, or all the little, oh look, it even comes with the key for the, There's a little keyhole here, and there's a little keyhole here. And so, yeah, for $189, it still has the original key. And it is in amazing condition. Yeah. Oh, every single one has a keyhole. Yeah, so this one would be where I would barely have to do anything to it, except for fix all the little scratch marks and refinish it. So yeah, I would probably sand this down and then stain it, and I would probably sell this for probably about $500 to $600, maybe even $700. When you are selling refurbished furniture or restored furniture, you always want to start high and work your way down, because people are always going to want to haggle you. So you want to start high, and then that way if you do get haggled, you kind of end up where you actually want to be. So look at this right here. Look at the color on that thing. That is really amazing. Don't get too close. That is awesome. I love this thing. This is the reason why I need a truck. Did you see the claw feet on it? How beautiful that is. Yeah, so this would definitely be something that I would buy. Like today. Alright, let's see what else we can find, guys. Okay, these are also good. These are also good to get. People enjoy the old milk crates. So if you can find them in really good condition, and if you can get them without having to do too much to them, and if you can get them for cheap, it's definitely good to get these. So, this one's actually $59. I don't want that to fall off. But yeah, these are always good to get. Oh, come back here, guys. Come check this out over here. Here, let me leave my cart out here. Come check this out. Okay, so look at these. These are $19 each. But this is exactly what I was trying to find for you guys. This is fake. This is not real wood. You can tell by the way, I hope you guys can see it on the video, but you can tell that this is a,
I don't know what it's called. It's like a vinyl covering, but you can tell that it's not real wood. You can tell by the way it sounds.
Like
a linoleum or kind of like a vinyl covering, yeah. You can tell that it's not real. So, especially by price and especially by the way it looks, you can tell this is fake. So this is not something that I would get. So I'm glad that I found this to be able to show you guys the difference between real and fake. Let's see if we can find something else like that too. Oh, look at the old, is that an old?
Oh, look at this old wedding dress.
That is beautiful.
That's really pretty. Look.
Hopefully I don't get lice from this. Hold on. I can't remember if the bows are supposed to go in the back or the front. Do I look good? Oh yeah, because I think that's supposed to go in front, huh?
Yeah.
It's hot out today. My hair is not working with me. It is so hot. And I was mentioning to Shay earlier, when we got here and we got out of the car to come inside, it's so weird, but Phoenix is probably about 45 minutes from Chandler, which is where I live, and it feels so much hotter here than it does in Chandler. I don't know, it's so weird. But it's hot out today. How do I look, babe?
You look
fantastic.
Fantastic.
I love those. Even those, I would never wear them. Probably never wear them. Don't forget my sunglasses. My beautiful sunglasses. I found these when I went to Albuquerque, when I went down to meet Stephen King. Found them for $6 in an Indian gift shop. They're pink and they're aviator glasses and I love them. I had to get them. I threw away my old sunglasses as soon as I found these. Well, look at this. This is like a little beach cubicle or whatever these things are called. Look at this. Oh, they're so cute. Oh, look at the little glass. Fish. Fishy, 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 fishy. If I find any glass animals here, I'm probably gonna have to get them depending on the price so I can fill up the type case that we are working on. Now that I have more compartments to fill. That's one of the reasons why I've been looking for a type case, because I can't stop with the glass animals. They're too cute.
All right, let's see what else we can find here.
Hi, guys! Are they twins?
Yeah!
Yeah! You get that question all the time, huh?
Every day, yeah.
We're recording, by the way.
Oh, you're good.
Yeah, I have a YouTube channel.
Oh,
so,
fun!
Yeah, I do refurbishing stuff, so.
Hey!
Hi, guys! What do you... Is that Rice Krispie treats?
No, they're these rice... bars from Costco.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
So they're like just munching on them.
I love them.
It's hot.
Oh yeah?
They're very good.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you guys enjoy your day, okay?
You too,
okay,
thank you.
Alright, let's see what else I can find for. I really do want to see if I can find more animals. Oh, look at the spice rack up there. I like that.
That was really cool.
So something else that I have been looking to find, I want to get one of those old like sewer trunks if I can find one of them for cheap, because I don't want to spend too much on it. Left or right? That is the question.
Right.
My right or your right?
Our rights are the same if we're facing the same direction.
I know. Left or right if I'm facing this way?
Right.
Okay. Oh, that's cool. Oh, look at this, babe. He's so colorful. He's so colorful.
You wanna swing down this way? Oh look, so here's another one of those, like, oh, this is gorgeous. I've been wanting to find one of these. Seriously, like, if I had $189 and I had a truck, I would have bought that one that I showed you guys just a little bit ago. But unfortunately, it wouldn't have fit in my tiny little car. Let's see if we can find a price on this. No price. Is there anything on the back?
I have no idea.
No, I don't see anything. Unfortunately, there's no price.
Nothing.
But it's beautiful. Okay. So here's something that you guys want to look at. See how it's wiggling? Oh, it comes out all together. That's why. Okay. That's probably something, if I were to buy this, I would probably screw that in.
Can I have dealer 521 to the front, please? Dealer 521 to the front. Mm-hmm. Oh, I don't want
a chair. It's got one little needle in it.
Let me tell you a funny story. When I was in sixth grade, for some stupid reason, I was playing with a sewing needle, a really big fat sewing needle, and I stuck it in my bed, but I stuck it in my bed upside down, and then I walked my friend home. I had it in my mattress upside down like this, and I walked my friend home, and I came home, and I forgot I put it in my mattress, and I sat down, and it went all the way in, and I had to have my mom pull it out of my butt cheek. And it was one of the thick sewing needles, the really thick ones.
Ouch.
That hurt. I was crying. Oh, look. Isn't this one of those old, oh yeah, look at this. See, this is something that you want to look for when you are buying something like this. You want to make sure it works. And if it doesn't, you want to make sure that you can fix it. I would not know how to fix something like this, but it is not moving, except for maybe like an inch. Yeah, and I wouldn't know how to fix that, so I wouldn't even bother getting it. But it's still really cool. It has like the old logo on it too. That was really cool. Now, I wish I was purchasing something today to show you guys like what I would get, but I have so many projects already started and I'm running out of room. So yeah, we're gonna get those taken care of first before I start anything else. And that's another video that I'm gonna do very soon, is I'm gonna go through the projects that I have planned so you guys can see what's to come. Check this out. I think that's handmade. Well, I guess everything's handmade, but you know what I mean? Like, that's pretty cool. It's $200. Old handmade bench from India. $200. That's pretty. I like the color on it. I actually want to learn how to do this. Baby, if you zoom in on this coloring, I want to learn how to do the different coloring, like, whatever that is called. That's really cool. It's on this too. Another good thing to get is shutters. So if you guys look here, good things to get is shutters because you can repurpose them. I like to use them a lot for like jewelry racks and stuff. A lot of people like to use them just to hang up and have as decoration. This is $8 and it is in very good condition. So this would be something that I would It works. It's in great condition. This would be something that I would sand down, get the paint off, and repaint, and either sell the way it is or turn it into something else, depending on what kind of idea I would come up with. But for $8, this is a really good buy. I like that. I'm trying to find something like really good. I have a thing for glass bottles. I don't know what it is, but I have a hoard of glass bottles that I'm trying to figure out what I want to do with. And Shay likes to scold me every time I bring another glass bottle home because...
I did not.
Well, you always say, why more? Because I haven't done anything with the glass bottles that I already have. Because, yeah. I'm thinking, though, like, it would be cool to clean them up and then, like, wrap, like the twine around them and make them into like cute vases. Okay, so we got I'm not seeing anything over there. I like this, even without the bottles, I like this. I want to go down this way, sorry, baby. I like these old, I can't think right now, the old, you know,
like
food containers. Yeah.
Oxism.
Alright, so I found heaven, guys. Shay's probably annoyed right now.
But no.
Look at all these little glass bottles. I would totally buy a bunch of them. But look at this. They're so gorgeous. This is 24. But yeah. It's a old whiskey bottle. This is a medical bottle. Dr. Miles. $15. I would get that too. And I like these like little ones like this. Ew, there is... Oh, someone put gum in there. That's disgusting.
Ew.
Yeah, that is completely... But it's a Lysol bottle. And it says Lysol, if you can see right here. It says Lysol right there.
So it won't focus.
No.
No.
If I can, like... But it says Lysol and really pretty curvy. But also, not only did I find these bottles, but I found this beautiful, very tall, probably like 7 feet. Look at this all the way down. Look at all these drawers.
How would you ever move something like this?
A big, huge... Here, let's go by
the way. Oh, I'm sorry.
I would love to have something like this for like all my arts and crafts, but I would have to get a stool to like get the top. I don't know what this music is, but let's go somewhere else because it's kind of annoying. Look at this. Oh, it's even Arizona. Arrowhead Restaurant. $14. I don't know what I would do with this, but I would buy it just because I like glass bottles, and I don't know why, but I have a thing for glass animals and rock animals and glass bottles. But I would probably just put this on the shelf because it's so cool. And look at this one. This one's really cool too. This is a Old Forester Kentucky Straight Bourbon Whiskey. 100 proof. Let's see if we can find a year on this thing. This whiskey is 4 years old. I don't think it's actually 4 years old. It was probably 4 years old when it was bought. But I don't see a year on it.
Let's see.
Hold on, look on
on the bottom. Right here. see. I don't know if that's a year or not, but it says 65.
Yes. No. I don't know.
I don't know if that's... Didn't...
Yeah, I don't know much about them. But it's definitely not 4 years old. There's even one back there with an old ship on it, but I'm not going to pick it up because I don't want to drop anything because I'm clumsy.
But...
Those look like this. The pots that Winnie the Pooh eats out of.
Right?
Look at all these ones. Look at this.
I also have a thing for the ball mason jars. I love these things. I actually have an idea that I want to do where I take a couple of these ball mason jars and I want to make like a chandelier lamp light thing out of them. I have it drawn out on paper. I'm still trying to... I have the idea, but the construction of it, I have to figure out, but yeah. Lemonade. This says lemonade. De Citron, France. That's pretty cool. Yeah, let's do a couple more aisles and then... I'll let you guys go because you guys are bored. What? Oh, look. Under 10. Eric Clapton.
Eric Clapton.
Netherlands. I don't know who that is.
I love old records.
The Moody Blues. Harry Chapin. John Denver. Elvis. The Birds and the Bees. Oh, the Birds, the Bees, and the Monkees.
Yeah, Monkees.
Art Garfunkel. Charlie Daniels.
Chicago.
Oak Ridge Boys. Carly Simon. Kenny Rogers. John Denver. Jesus Christ Superstar. The Ventures. Neil Diamond.
Yeah.
Jimmy Buffett. Son of a sailor. Dolly Parton. Oh, damn. She's like young in this picture.
Yep.
What year was this? That was 5 years before I was born. I just disclosed my age. That makes me sad.
Now you're 21, babe.
Yes, I am 21. I also like Japanese things for my own personal whatnot. Not anything I would sell, but I really enjoy the Japanese culture. Look at this. This is really cool. What is it? Iron trivet. It's like a little...
Will that be used for just decoration?
Yep. Yeah, I'll just clean it up, hang it up on the wall. For own personal use, this wouldn't be anything I'd sell. And we're moving past this. We don't want to look at that. We don't look at all. Okay, look at this right here. I have no idea how excited I am. I got it. This is really cool. $133. This is beautiful. Now I actually have a chandelier that I'm going to be restoring for you guys. I can't wait to show you. It's an old gothic, like vintage gothic chandelier. It is like wood and iron. It is absolutely gorgeous. I can't wait for that video because that one's going to be really cool. What is this?
It's a treasure chest.
Yes.
Is there gold in there?
No, I can't open it. Treasure is lost forever.
Look at this wooden mallet. Mishmash.
Oh, that's
like
cool.
Like a caveman.
I like that. Look at those, like, death tools over there. Babe, look! They're so cute! I don't know why I like these things. They're just... Adorable. Look at this one. This is not glass though. This feels more like hard plastic.
Yeah.
Still cute though. But these are glass, I can tell. You can tell by the way you pick it up. Like, this is really light, and this one's more heavy.
Yeah, these are absolute.
Yeah.
You can feel. You can tell.
Like this, yeah. As soon as I pick this up, I could tell it's glass.
Glass is cold and hard plastic.
And someone decided to eat a Werther's original. Ew. Look at this. Look at the top of this. That's cool.
It's like a mad scientist.
Wow. Look at the little elephants! I kind of like, I want to walk away with like one thing to put in my type case. Like, I want to like hang it up and be like, my victory, like I got it done, let's put this on here kind of thing. Maybe I can find like a cute little like vase or something to put in there. We'll see what we can find. Oh, look, okay. Hold on. What's all this? Okay, so my wonderful boyfriend just pointed this stuff out. I buy stuff like this. I make, like I mentioned before, jewelry racks, and I like to buy knobs. Because I screw the knobs into planks of wood that I paint, and then the necklaces hang from these. I don't really like the way this gold looks though. I buy more stuff like this. Like this would be really cool. But this you wouldn't be able to hang anything from. This would be cool to get. How much are these? $1.86? I don't know. I don't know, because I could get it from Hobby Lobby for that price, and the ones at Hobby Lobby are a lot prettier. But this is cool, I like that one. That's $1.86 though. But see, my boyfriend knows me. He knows me so well.
Sorry, I'm like the worst cameraman on the planet.
Yeah, I know.
Because I get distracted by all this cool stuff, and I'm not even looking at what I'm filming.
Yeah, I'm going to put this to the side because I see stuff back here, so if we could squeeze back here. Not really anything too interesting though. I like old, like. It's starting to get really hot, like I feel like I'm I love Arizona for like 8 to 9 months out of the year. The other 3 to 4 months, I despise it. I despise it. But I love the winters here. I really do. So we're like backing up. Like Shay's like.
Just don't let me break anything.
He is trying to back up without knocking anything over because these little booths are so tightly, like stuffed with stuff.
Yeah, and if I knock over the wrong thing, I might be in debt the rest of my life.
Right? Yeah, unfortunately. It's a laughing matter, but it's no laughing matter.
Yeah, it is.
Look at this. It's a cool little. Oh, look, it's like one of those like butter churners.
You wanna make your own butter?
Oh my god, it's so heavy! Holy cow! Look inside this though. No, this is and it's not butter, it's ice cream. See, because you put the, you put ice right here, and you put all the stuff in here to make the ice cream, and then you sit and you sit here and you turn and turn and turn and turn. You do it like this. On my first birthday, actually, we did homemade ice cream. Not that I remember, but I have seen the pictures. And I saw pictures of me helping my papaw, and I was sitting there like trying to turn it. It was dirty. See, this is what I was talking about several minutes ago. I want to find one of these things. So like, this is $89. This is not bad at all. I don't want to pick that stuff up though. Hey guys, so unfortunately my camera stopped recording. After the end of what you guys just saw. I don't know what happened. Shay thought it was recording. I thought it was recording. But it literally stopped, but it looked like it was recording. So unfortunately you guys didn't get to see everything that I was showing you, even though it wasn't recording. I'm so sad. But yeah, we're already gone. We've already left. We're on our way to Shay's grandma's house. So I'll definitely be taking you guys back again. And we just went over a bump and another bump. But we're about to hit a collision. Hold on. No collision, I'm just kidding. But we will definitely be going back to the bigger one in Goodyear because there's so many awesome items. And I do want to take you guys back again because I had so much fun shopping with you guys. I did end up leaving with one item. I didn't want to get too much, but I did find one item. I found this tiny little jar. I told you that I wanted to find one thing to put in the type case. So I found this tiny little jar. It says poison on it and it has a little skull and crossbones. So I had to get it. I was so excited. It was $10. A little expensive for this tiny little thing, but it was cool. So yeah, so I'm excited. I'm kind of sad that you guys didn't get to see the rest of the video. I don't think we recorded that much after where it cut off, but still. But yeah, stupid camera. But anyway, you guys have a wonderful day. I had so much fun today. Thank you guys for joining me and watching this video. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.